Hello everyone, my name is Dylan, and I'm an engineering technologist from Dell's VxRail technical marketing team. We're taking this time to look at the update process for VxRail clusters and discussing some of the benefits built into it. Let's go ahead and dive in. Updating data center infrastructure is rarely a simple task. Executing the update packages themselves is easy enough, but numerous other considerations exist. For example, when I was in support, many of the customers that I worked with had issues keeping their hardware versions up to date because of the high volume of files needed to cover all their components. Plus, you have all the time that's required to apply each package to each node. I'll be updating this 4-node cluster to release 7.0.400. You could update as many as 64 nodes in the same process, however. We're in a standard ESXi cluster, updates are built from the ground up. VxRail uses continuously validated states to accelerate through these kind of manual processes. This bundling eliminates the difficulty related to sourcing files, and VxRail system software manages the majority of the update cycle. Once this bundle upload completes, we can start our pre-check by providing the vCenter and VxRail credentials. VLCM runs a pre-check, so you might think that these pre-checks are the same. VxRail massively extends this pre-check, looking at both hardware health and the services running throughout the software stack. This extended pre-check helps make updating VxRail clusters more successful more often. We'll follow up on this pre-check with a change report. We also have the option to customize the update to include additional components, such as a GPU driver in a V-series node, or fiber channel controller drivers in a dynamic node cluster that would be connected to SAN storage. We won't be customizing this update, but this does help provide additional flexibility to the update process. I'll go ahead and provide the credentials and update the cluster now. We could choose to update the cluster later if we needed to run after business hours or even over the weekend. It looks like our update will take just about 4 hours, and this confirms that we'll be moving to version 7.0.400. Clusters with more nodes do take longer to update. This is because the jobs run sequentially. And it may not be as visible now, but with larger cluster sizes, the additional automation that VxRail provides to the update cycle dramatically reduces the work required from IT staff. You can see that our update job has completed and our new software version. This entire job would complete without disrupting business workloads thanks to vMotion cycling VMs to available nodes and VxRail orchestration between the nodes. Large customers with multiple VxRail clusters will want to investigate the VxRail API and Cloud IQ. Both of these have features to help with updating multiple clusters, and both will be featured in a later video. Thanks for watching this video today. I've been your host, Dylan Jackson, and this has been a look at the enhancements that VxRail provides to the cluster update process. I hope you'll join me in the follow-on video for cluster integrity. Have a great day!